Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. In the previous video, video number 10, we talked about oneDNN, oneAPI deep neural network library. We've seen that you can get the oneDNN binaries in the oneAPI base toolkit, and of course, on GitHub. Just Google git oneDNN, and you can find here the source code, for example, for CPU, for example, on x64 architecture, and you can find here the actual implementation of the library functions or primitives. You can also find here, under examples, tutorials and code snippets, a great way to learn. The easiest way to try it out, maybe even on a new hardware from Intel, is using the Intel Dev Cloud. Google it, apply, it only takes a few clicks. Once you get the email with the link, you have the full access. You can just open a Linux terminal and you can start running the benchmark on the sample. No need to install anything, you're all set, just start coding. Another way is to navigate to the oneAPI samples, libraries, oneDNN, tutorials, and you can open a Jupyter notebook for, say, the getting started tutorials and just follow the instructions to get the content and run the samples step by step. Maybe the best way to introduce you to the programming model is by an example. So let's build an implementation step by step. The first thing we need is a structure for the input and the output. A memory type will define them. In many cases, we also need the weights as an input data. And here is the actual operation. A primitive is a real mathematical or logical function to execute. We can create it, hopefully only once, to save the overhead, and then execute it as many times as needed, and then destroy it. Using postops, you can concatenate or fuse certain operations, and by that, obviously, can boost the performance to form what is called a stream. And this stream is working on an engine. An engine is the device that actually executes the stream. It could be an Intel CPU, an NVIDIA GPU, or many others. Let's look at the getting started example. We are using DNNL namespace. First, we define the engine, the target device. Then we define the stream that will run on my engine. Here is the memory description, the data layout, format, and so on. And we use this format to define the input, output, and if needed, the weights. Now we have the memory structures in place. We are performing ReLU operations, so there's no really need in weights for this example. And we even write the input data to the source. In this example, it's an image. And now comes the operation itself. We define a ReLU operation and a ReLU primitive descriptor, which is an actual implementation of ReLU to a specific engine, specific target device. And we create the primitive and execute the stream, which has only one primitive in this case, but can hold many. Now, we just need to wait for the stream to finish the execution and then read the results into the output buffer. oneDNN has much more to offer. You can read all about it in the documentation. For example, the connection to VTune analyzer. VTune automatically detects the JIT code of oneDNN. It can recognize the primitives and provide you all the statistics you need to trace and debug the performance. We have seen the oneDNN programming model and concepts. We have seen where to get the code, and we have explored the getting started example. You can communicate with the design team on GitHub, ask questions, request enhancements, or provide feedback. And you can follow these links for further information. Good luck.